Hello, everyone. My name is Aaron, but you can also call me Enigma. And welcome to a brand new game that just released. It's called Everybody Goes to the Rapture. I really don't know what to say about this game. It's an exploration-based narrative game that focuses on the end of the world. And the game is told through interacting with elements of the environment, and you figure out what happened to this world, as seemingly we are the last person left alive. And these imprints, like of these memories of people, are left in this wasteland, this landscape that you have to explore, and we're just trying to piece together the story. So, without further ado, I present to you Everybody Goes to the Rapture.
This is Dr. Catherine Collins. I don't know if anyone will ever hear this. It's all over. I'm the only one left.
So, the Chinese Room, if that name is familiar to anybody who's watching the video, that is the team that helped develop Amnesia, a Machine for Pigs. And they also created Dear Esther, I'm pretty sure. Visuals are crazy, though. Oh my god, is it already playable? This is me controlling. Wow. There's not even like an intro screen or anything. It's just... I guess so. We're that Catherine Collins, I'm pretty sure. So let's go in. Oh, radio. This is what's making the noise.
I'm going to continue to broadcast for as long as I am able. If I'm right, we should be able to pick up the signal right across the valley. The event has left markers. We don't understand it yet, but we're going to keep working to try and understand it. You can use them to find what you're looking for. The answers, they're all here. The answers are in the light.
Okay, so like I may or may not have said, depending on whether or not how much I leave in, we're going to be interacting with these little etheric light things that kind of float around, and that's how we figure out what happened to this place. I don't know what that is. Well, I just turned on the computer, so maybe that has something to do with something. So these are maps of stars. I really have no clue what that's for. I hear, like, there's a lot of audio cues going on right now. So apparently, I guess we're not Kate. I guess Kate's on the radio, just listening to, like, the cues that are going around. Like, I can hear wildlife. I thought I heard, like, a train whistle or something. There's like a cell phone. Is this right? Yeah, it's right here.
This is a special announcement by the Emergency Measures Committee. Due to exceptional circumstances, radio and television in this area has been brought under the control of the EMC as per the Crisis Preparedness and Action Bill of 1982. Keep your radio and television on at all times. Stay indoors and avoid contact with other people. Do not attempt to telephone outside your local area. Do not panic and remain civil and calm. Stay tuned to this station for updates.
So yeah, I should also mention, this game takes place during the 80s, I'm pretty sure. So I did say that was a cell phone ringer, but that was just some type of, like, you know, emergency channel radio thing that they had going on. I mean, really, this is the only way... Oh, What the hell is that? Well, I guess there's nothing in this car. So yeah, this is a very different playthrough for me. This is solely based on exploration. I really know nothing about it, since they haven't really given away that much information about the game, so why don't we just learn together? Like right there. That's one of the lights. So wait a minute, I'm turning the controller.
I'm trying to do my job. You two will be the only staff on site for this rotation. I'm just saying, if the main gate's power fails, then there's no way in or out of the observatory.
That's why there are backup generators. Jesus, why the hell are we even discussing this?
Just don't you come running to me if you get locked in.
If we get locked in, we won't be able to come running to you, will we? You let us worry about the clever stuff, and you can concentrate on sweeping up leaves and changing light bulbs. Happy? Now piss off.
Asshole.
That was unnecessary. Just because you're angry with me doesn't mean you have to take it out on everyone else.
Kate, can we just talk about this?
No, Steven, I'm done. I just want to get out of this place, and tonight is our best chance of doing that. You prep the arrays, I'm heading up to Tower 6.
Kate. I love you. You know that, right?
Yeah, I know that. Come on, let's get started.
So that's Kate. Oh. Wow. Wow, it's daytime now. So that is Kate from the radio. And these are like the little light things that I was telling you about that you can interact with. And they kind of paint the picture of what happened before this, you know, the event, as they call it. The end of the world. Oh, it's saving. I guess I just hit a checkpoint. And that's how we figure out the backstory. So we've been introduced to Kate, Steven, and Graham? Was that Graham or Grammy or... I don't know. I'm not always the best at pronouncing names. So yeah, this game, like I said, it takes place during the 80s, I believe, at some point, and it's in London. And we got another little ball of light here. Jeremy, what is... I mean, there's no way for me to run. The only button that I've been able to use so far is X. I guess we're gonna go ahead and see what's up with Jeremy over here. Oh!
Well, I suppose from that we can assume that they really are serious about this whole quarantine thing. If Mrs. Boughton wandered off that way before they closed the road, I suspect we'll never find her. Not until this whole thing blows over.
Well, it's more than a little odd. I mean, this is Yorton, for goodness sake. There was no need for them to be so rude.
Well, if they are so concerned that they are willing to close off the roads, I suspect they would argue that there is every need. What is certain is that for the time being, none of us are going anywhere.
But he had a rifle, a soldier with a rifle, in Shropshire. The world's gone stark raving mad. I've a good mind to write to my MP.
You do that, Barb, and I'll personally deliver it for you. Once this blockade is removed anyway. Come on, Bob. I can't spend all day chasing pensioners around the valley. The surgery won't open itself. I need to grab some paracetamol when we get back as well. Fucking headache all of a sudden.
Hmm. It looked like that light led me over to this area, where then I could interact with Dr. Wade and Barbara. Well, not interact with them, but hear their past conversation. So yeah, the place that we are, we're at Yarton, or Yarton, however you pronounce it. I already forgot. Is this like a secret path? Like, can we go down here? Nah, I guess not. Just a nice little quaint countryside town. Probably spelled T-O-W-N-E. Townie. As this is ye old Yarton. So... automatically, what I'm gaining from this game, just based on the audio cues, are that the event, as it's being called, it seems to have wiped out the people, but left these imprints, and there's wildlife, because I can hear birds. I'm sure you can, too. I'm sure it's coming through. All right, so here we go. Yachtin. Oh, phone's ringing. I mean, I would assume it's for me, since nobody else is here.
Who's that? Hello?
Kate, if you can hear this, you need to shut down the optical array. It's using the observatory as a conduit to reach us, and it started spreading its range beyond the valley. Kate, we can't afford to let it do that. It's getting stronger. I'm going to call Clive back, and I'm going to force him to order the strike. I just don't see what other choice we have. God knows
Can you hear me? We need help.
Who are you?
Jesus, get off the phone! Get off the phone! It's in the phone!
It's in the phones.
It's in the phones? What the fuck is going on? So whatever the event is, it's something. It isn't just like an event, like a nuclear war or something. Something actually has invaded or it's taken over the area. Welcome to Yachtin. Please drive carefully. Well, that doesn't even apply anymore. All right, well, we'll just continue down the road, as that's the only place I can go right now. Oh. I understand that those things are most likely here to help us, but they're still really creepy. And it was stopped here. Oh, here's another event.
Don't be so hard on yourself. We've all had rejections.
You haven't.
Come on. We'll look at the figures, tighten up the data, and resubmit. Your core idea is sound. You just got the number slightly wrong.
Don't patronize me.
I'm not patronizing you. I think you are a brilliant man, Dr. Appleton. Listen. I'm here, right? We're together, you and me. The alignment event tomorrow. It's yours, okay? You saw the opportunity, you ran the numbers. Even if they can't see it, I'm proud of you.
Is that supposed to make me feel better?
Steven. Look on the bright side, I'm around here. You're a hero. Prodigal son returns, right? I'm surprised they haven't erected a statue in your honor yet.
Oh, you can laugh all you want. But I'll bet the parish council have a subcommittee working on that right now.
All right. So that event's over with now. I like how it goes to nighttime whenever there is, like, a conversation that we have to listen to. Valis, say no to Valis extension. Is a seven tower really necessary? Because she had talked about tower number six, so I wonder what's going on here. Derek, you massive dickhead wanker. Oh, man. Raffle, could your number be up? Oh, now that's a foreshadowing event. So Shropshire, that's where Barbara, she was talking about Shropshire. That's where the Valis Observatory. Wait, were we? Yeah, you are here. So we're down towards the bottom down there. And then the road goes all the way up. I bet you this entire map is explorable. I bet you this is the game. And we will go everywhere. Jim is a massive knobhead. And then Kolk, as the Brits would pronounce it. What I really like, though, about the game so far, and this is just an initial impression, is I like how you're given these character profiles. Listen to that music, too. You're given these character profiles just solely based on voice acting. So you don't get a chance to know what the characters look like. So you have no preconceived notions based on appearance. It's all based on, you know, vocal cues and what they're actually saying. I hear another one of those radios. Yeah, there it is. Oh, there's another light over there. I still don't trust those things. Can we actually go through, like, these gates? We can! Holy moly! I've probably been able to go through some of these gates and not even known it. I'm just going to explore a little bit. I'll let you know if I find anything. So now, whether or not I decide to leave this in, I ended up walking back up the road a little bit to see if I could open up those other gates, just to kind of see if there was, like, any Easter eggs or anything. I assume I could probably open up a gate, if that's a gate right there. Oh! What the hell? Maybe this... Yeah, I think this is just telling me to, like, go back. Yeah, so if you go off, you know, off the beaten path, this kind of helps you get back on track. We'll head back here. Can you actually go inside the house? No. It's locked. Oh, bees. Well, I didn't find anything. So let's go ahead and check out this radio here. The Voice of the Stars.
Extraordinary. The whole thing reminds me of high school. Seeing Mars for the first time. That same rush of excitement. My hands are shaking.
I mean, it seems like Kate and Steven are astrologists or astronomers, I believe would be the correct term. It seems like they have a working knowledge of our universe. What's going on in here? Look at this weasel bike. It's a pretty sick bike. I get the weird feeling, though, that I'm being watched. Like, I feel like you're not alone in this game. And I hate the noise of those lights. It's hard to describe. It sounds hostile, but familiar. Alright, well, that one's going way up the road. I'm not going after that one yet. I'll check out the stars at night. Closed until further notice. We've got the flu. Please try the seventh Whistler. We'll be back in business as soon as we're up and about. George and Helen Gables. We can go in here, though. Ale of the day, 50p. It sounds like there's another radio in here, though. Is it in the baño, the bathroom? Oh my god, there's still smoke coming off of a cigarette. That means somebody's been here recently. Well, we don't want to go outside yet. Can we actually go behind the bar? That doesn't seem like it. As I was mentioning before, it seems like this game is very... I don't know how to describe it. It's like an uneasy feeling as you're going through here. Like, you don't feel like you're alone. You feel like there's something else going on. I hear a radio in here. Where is it? Oh, there it is. It's right over here. It was outside this whole time.
I keep looking, but it makes no sense. The area we picked the pattern up from can no longer be located on the scope. That's just not possible. You can see significant changes to the quality of the ambient light in that part of the sky. It's overexposed, like a Polaroid left in direct sunlight.
So evidently they've witnessed something in you know, their studies of the stars and of the sky that isn't right, or it's an anomaly of some sort.
You know, they see me as an outsider here as well.
Is that supposed to make me feel any better?
You know, I understand it's difficult. That's all I'm saying. Your lot up at Vallis have never mixed with the local community. People here, they don't really understand what you do up there.
Are you trying to get me to come to your church?
It's not just about faith. It's about the community. Be involved. Be seen as part of it. One of them.
Good morning, Father. Lovely day. Oh, hello. Mrs. Appleton, isn't it?
It's Dr. Collins.
Lady scientist. Whatever next?
Good morning, Barbara.
Father Wheeler. You really think that's a community that will ever see me as one of them? I can live with them staring at me. If they just stay out of my way.
So, Kate is a female scientist, which at this point is probably not as common in London. But Jeremy Wheeler, he is the father of the church, like the preacher of the church. And then Barbara is just, she was the lady who we had heard from before. All right, well now we have a very big area to explore. We can go to any one of these homes. I guess we'll start on the left and we'll work our way up. I'm sure, is that a, oh, that's the church up there. I was like, is that a castle? I'm sure though, depending on where you go, I'm sure that influences the story to an extent. I know that they did say this game, you can go anywhere at any time. Like, the story doesn't, it isn't, you know, held to a particular standard of you have to go here first, then here, then here. Oh, we can go in the house. Yo, check out this kitchen. This is an older kitchen. Alright, well, we'll check out, like, the living room area first. Right now, if that's any significant time, 6:07. We'll keep that in mind, just in case it's significant. Whoa. I hear the light outside. Where is it? I see it.
Hello? Hello? Oh, Amanda, I thought you'd left town.
Tried. We did try, but they've closed all the roads and you can't get through. And then Georgie and Ben said they had headaches, and then they started bleeding. And it was horrible. They were so scared. So Neil turned the car around, and we saw the house was open. And I know we shouldn't have, but we just came in to clean up the kids, and then Neil and I started bleeding as well, and it's all over my blouse. Everyone was so tired.
It's all right, Amanda. Everything will be all right. Just try and calm down and tell me where Neil and the children are.
They're upstairs. They were tired, and Neil said they could take a nap in the bed, and Neil thought Barbara wouldn't mind as they're only children, and I was so tired, so Neil took them up. He took them upstairs to tuck them in.
And?
That was 6 hours ago. He never came back down. Just be too frightened to go and look.
Why don't we go and look together? I can hold your hand if you like.
Yeah. I think I could manage that, yes. Will you please help me?
Of course I'll help you. Neil? Neil, are you there?
Oh, boy. So now I'm gonna have to go upstairs and look. So we've just been introduced some new information. Apparently, whatever has been afflicting this town makes you bleed. I mean, after seeing that, you have to go upstairs. If there are any jump scares, man. There's a teddy bear. There's some blood. What is that picture? Mummy? Oh. What was that? I thought I heard a muffled voice. Why is that door locked? Oh no. That door's locked too. All of these doors are locked. This is the only one that's open. I mean, there's a Simon Says. So, Is that it? Is that it to the story? Oh my god. So the father came in to tuck in the kids upstairs and just never came back down. All of these papers are everywhere. Holy crap. Oh. Okay, so this is the one that leads into the kitchen. So it just looped around everywhere again anyway. Well, that was a creepy house. That was super, super creepy. Ah. I don't like how the gate opens up like that. I assume we're not going to be able to open up this one, but I mean, you never know. So we've got a little bit more to go on. Apparently, whatever is afflicting these people is making them bleed, and they become very tired. Oh my god. I almost regret going to that house. Oh, there's a little light down in the park. Should we check out the park next? Yeah, we'll check out the park. Okay, so the water moves when we walk through it. So presumably we're real. Because I would like to think if we were like a figment of someone's imagination or something like that, we wouldn't be able to manipulate water. Where are you going, little light? I wanted to go to the park, but okay, I guess I'm following you now. I wonder how they divide, like, the story up. Like, is this, like, Jeremy's storyline, or is this something else? And this is, I do not like this alleyway. We are going way too far out of the way where I want to go. Oh! What the hell, dude? I just followed you all the way over here. I don't even know, man. I'm gonna head to, there's gotta be something in this park here. I'm gonna head to this little area. So this is another map, a little bit different. You are here. What are those little... Oh! It just sounded like something was running. What the fuck? This is creepy. Being that I'm over by this little white house, we'll go over here. God, I am so sorry I'm kind of skipping around here, but there's a lot to take in. All right, so that was house number 4. Can't go in the back either. I don't know if that one over there was 3. We'll have to take a spin and see if that one was 3. But I do know that there was a radio back here, so we might as well, while we're here, we'll check out the radio in this garden area. We can't go in that way anyway. Is the radio in here? Yes, it is. Okay, perfect.
The magnetic field is causing disruptions to phone signals and the rest of the electrics. There are voices on the line. It's 4 a.m. Maybe everyone is up looking at the light show.
All right, so there was some type of maybe meteor shower or like... Oh, that light. That light is creepy. Can we actually go in through this back door? Nope. That house must be off limits. We're gonna go down the creepy alley. We're gonna check it out. And we're gonna see what this place has to offer. Oh wait, that was one of the little butterflies on the map. I see that. See on the door, there was that little map we were looking at, and it was one of those like little butterfly symbols. I don't know about this. Wow, that looks ominous. I'm just knocking on the door. It's number 18? That has to have some sort of significance. See, that's what I love about this game. Even though there's not a lot of, like, gameplay elements, it's just exploration. You're still, you're having to fend for yourself and piece together these events.
You have to make a decision, Lizzie. Especially now.
I do love him, Father. I love them both.
He's married. There are other people involved in this.
Oh, I hardly think that anyone's in the position to claim the moral high ground, do you?
Well, I take your point about Stephen. And Robert, but I think Kate might see things differently.
Do you? I mean, she's not screwing anyone else, pardon my French, but she spends all day and night locked up in that observatory. Stephen says they barely see each other. That's hardly a marriage, is it?
Wait. Stephen and Kate are married? What? I did not see that coming. Based on their interaction, like, I knew that they had some type of relationship, but it almost kind of seemed like he liked her. Obviously, he said he loved her, but it almost seemed like she was indifferent towards him. I'm already calling it. I've been playing this game for almost 45 minutes now. If the climax of the game, like, builds up to this point where we interact with another human, like, if someone else is alive, that's gonna be so meaningful after just having nothing but interactions with lights.